Hello and welcome to all students. In this lecture, we study the congruence relation on shade. And today we learn about the subtopic equivalence classes on shade. Or we see the partition of the set of integers. Okay, so this is the outline of our lecture. First of all, we see the introduction, then one example on partition of Z, and some remarks. In the previous lecture, we saw one theorem. Two integers a and b are congruent modulo a positive integer n if and only if they leave the same remainder when divided by n. Okay, so if we divide by n to the integers a and b, and if they leave the same remainder, then we can say that a and b are, then we can say that two integers a and b are congruent modulo n. Okay, so in the last lecture we saw the proof of this theorem. So this is the proof: let a is equal to a congruence b modulo n, and let us take a is congruent to b modulo n, and then show that n divides, and then show that a and b leave the same remainder when divided by n. So you see here, as if I take a is congruent to b, a is congruent to b modulo n, then n must divide the difference a minus b. Therefore, there exists an integer k such that a minus b must be in multiple of n. That is, a minus b is equal to n k, and a is equal to b plus n k. Okay, consider b, and let us assume that when divided by n, it leaves a remainder r. Therefore, b is equal to nq plus r, and where q and r are integers, such that r is greater equal 0, strictly less than n. So this is the condition on the remainder. R is always greater than or equal to 0, and it is strictly less than n. So substituting for b in a is equal to b plus nk, we get a equal to nq plus r plus nk, and therefore a is equal to n into bracket q plus k plus r. R is greater equal 0, less than n, which means by the uniqueness of quotient and remainder in division algorithm, that when a is divided by n, it also leaves the same remainder r. Okay, it also leaves the same remainder r. So thus, whenever a leaves the remainder r, whenever a is congruent to b modulo n, then when we divide by n to both a and b, then a and b leave the same remainder r. Okay, so now in the reverse case, conversely, suppose that the two integers a and b are such that when divided by n, they leave the same remainder, say r. Therefore, a equal to nq plus r and b equal to nq dash plus r. So what is r? Is the remainder, and which is greater equal 0 less than n. For some quotients q and q dash in shade. So if I take a subtraction of these two equations, a minus b is equal to n into bracket q plus q dash, which means that n divides a minus b. Therefore, a is congruent to b. So this, by definition of congruence relation, we can say that a is congruent to b mod n as required. Okay, thus we have proved this theorem. Now we see the partition of Z. Okay, we have a remark. The important consequence of this theorem, or the important consequence of the above theorem, is as follows. Let n is equal to 6. Therefore, these integers leave the same remainder, will be congruent to one another. Now, the remainders in this case are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Consider the subset whose elements are 0, 6, 12, 18, 24, comma dot dot dot, and negative elements minus 6, minus 12, minus 18, minus 24, comma dot 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 of integers. Any two numbers of this set will be congruent to each other as their common remainder is 0 when they are divided by 6, which is also a member of 0 is also a member of this set. Let us label this subset of Z by 0 bar. So 0 bar is equal to, therefore 0 bar is equal to set 0, 0 bar is a set containing the elements 0, 6, 12, 18, 24, comma dot dot dot, minus 6, minus 12, minus 18, minus 24, comma dot dot dot. Similarly, we have 1 bar is equal to 1, 7, 13, 19, 25, comma dot dot dot, minus 5, minus 11, minus 17, minus 23. So see here, 1 bar means it is the set of all those integers. 1 bar means, what is that set? It is the set of all those integers which leaves the remainder 1 when divided by 6. Okay, when divided by 6. Now 2 bar is the set, it is the set of all those integers which leaves the remainder 2 when divided by 6. So 2 bar is the set of the numbers 2, 8, 14, 20, 26, comma dot dot dot, minus 4, minus 10, minus 16, minus 22. So similarly, we write the set of 3 bar, 4 bar, and 5 bar. So if I write a set of 6 bar, then that set 6 bar will contain the element same as the elements in the set 0 bar. The subsets 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar can also be written as R bar such that R is greater or equal to 0, less than or equal to 5. They have the following properties. Every member of R bar leaves the same remainder R which when divided by 6. Every two members of R bar are congruent to each other modulo 6. These subsets are disjoint for different values of R. Also, these subsets together constitute Z. So, first property says that set R bar contains the members of Z which leave the same remainder R when divided by 6. Second property says that any two members of the set R bar are congruent modulo 6. And third property says that so all these sets they are disjoint or they are different. They are disjoint. There is no common element in all these six sets. Also, these sets, if I take a union of all these six sets, you will get the set of integers. A pictorial representation of Z along with these subsets is given in the following figure. So, first row contains the name of sets 0 bar 1, first column, sorry, 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar. And on the right hand side, we have corresponding set elements in that set. So on the right hand side, in the second column, if we take a union of all these elements, you will see that, you will observe that, that union will gives the set of integers. So, from the above figure, it appears that the subsets 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar are partitioning the set of integers Z. So, this is nothing but the partition of set of integers Z, okay, in 6 sets. The above result is true for any positive integer n. The remainder the remainders in this case will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, comma dot 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 up to n minus 1. And therefore the subsets will be 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, comma dot 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 n minus 1 bar. These subsets are called equivalence classes or residue classes of Z modulo n, and they partition Z into n subsets. Okay, so this is the example of partition of Z. Partition of Z. So if I take n, you can take n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Okay, so So now I will give a one homework for the students. Let us take n equal to 8 and write all the partitions of the set of integers. Okay, so if I take n equal to 8 and write all partition sets or write all equivalence classes in case of n equal to 8 for the set of integers. Okay, now this is your homework, and we stop here. For any query you can contact, and thank you very much.